Sunan.
With Heminger Yard gone, can Lily hold the reins? Will he guide us true?
You are the wolf-kissed one. The raven of battle whose fame grows with each waxing of the moon.
I struggle with the choice Heminger left for me. I would have your counsel on the matter.
A slaughter must be made. Many sheep at the bottom of the sleeping Jotun, before the pyre is lit. Follow. Come, creatures. You are to serve the gods and bid them welcome our beloved Hemingurjak with ale and open arms.
You have the gift of foresight, Seer. Can you augur what is to come?
I see what need be seen, when it need be.
A great gift.
A great burden.
Did Heminger Jarl consult you often? Did he unburden his woes?
We spoke often. Yet too often he left with more burdens than he brought.
He worried about the future of his clan. About who would be Jarl.
Speak less. Lest our words draw foul spirits to dog us.
As you wish. Volga, I...
Your heart is restless. Your mind clouded. You seek more than a guarantee of good omens.
I seek the gods' wisdom.
You wish to know who would best serve this clan as Jarl?
I do. Between Vili and Trukvi, there's no clear choice.
We stand in the shadow of the giant, the great keeper of secrets. Here, you'll find a drink of the resounding sea. Ascend the sleeping Jotun, consume the waters, and meditate at its peak. Do not seek answers to your questions. They will find you.
What do you see? Thank you. This is the summit. To seek an answer, I should clear my mind and still my heart. Mingo Yao, is it truly you?
Of spirit, not of flesh.
Why have you not reached Odin's Hall?
I will in time. As the flames of my pyre burn, I will ride the path of wood smoke to the All-Father's Hall of Champions.
I am grateful to see you once more, Jarl. I struggle with the task you set before me. To choose your heir is not an easy thing. One man is beloved, but does not want the task. The other man is fit for the task, but is not favored.
I could not give you any more counsel in life, Eivor. So too in death, am I rendered silent.
Forget wise counsel and rational arguments. What does your heart tell you?
My heart is stopped. It says nothing.
This should not be my decision, Heminger. The choice was always yours to make. You were their chief.
As Sigurd is your chief. But that does not quench your appetite for glory, as you covet his place upon the high seat of your clan.
I do not seek to replace Sigurd. Fate weaved our futures long ago. We are only following its pattern.
Yet you see it coming. You welcome it.
Shall I renounce my fate, then? Abandon the path to glory I walk?
No. I want you to die in defense of it.
Uncertain.
Your edge is blunted by indecision. You late warriors now. Never waver.
You did, Jarl. You did.
And that is why my words should land true. Trust your judgment.
cursed me, Heminger. I never intended this.
Have no regrets, Eivor. You have given me the great battle death I sought in life.
You old fox. Was that the point of riling me up?
Father. He comes to welcome me to his hall, and I must follow. The choice you make will be the right one.
You have seen what was needed?
I have. More than enough.
when she is so well. Gunnar's craft never disappoints.
And here, from the Raven Clan.
An impressive shield.
It is good, but it needs a touch of grandeur. Something personal for your father. A sigil, I think. A mark to adorn the front. We need an artisan. Is there one in the village?
I know a man. A master craftsman in exile. He lives in a cave northeast of Hemsop. I would take you there myself, but I have Isbjorn to retrieve.
Isbjorn? Your father's spear? Did he not wield it at Ulkerthorpe?
He lost it some winters back on a bear hunt. He hit the beast hard, but the spear stuck and the bear fled into the forest.
And after all these winters, you hope to find it again and present it to the pyre. The odds are narrow, to say the least.
Fret not, friend. I have a nose for these things. Seek out the exile. He'll see to your shield.
Stretch your
This must be the cave Billy mentioned. Who would live here? Exile must value his solitude, living in a hole such as this. Odin's beard. You are a difficult man to find. Heminger Jarl is dead. I was told you are a master craftsman. I seek an etching on the shield to celebrate the life and death of Heminger Jarl.
the stones. Heminger Jarl possessed a steady hand and steady heart. Do you possess the same? Steady.
How could it be at such a time?
Heminger Jarl's heart never wavered.
In life it did not, but in death it lies as still as a stone. You have not yet answered me. Will you help me with my etching?
How will you remember him?
By his wisdom, always an inspiration.
The web of Wirthen. Nine lines that write our fates. Past, present, and future entwined. Is this what you desire?
Yes, I choose this one.
I will begin.
How did you come to be here?
Fate. I was given a death sentence. Unfairly, I felt. But a man was killed. Heminger Jarl desired for me to live. The villagers did not. My sight and exile. That was our compromise.
Thank you for this.
His son will take his place.
That is for Vili to decide.
Vili has no say. Fate has already decided.
Heminger will be pleased with our gift. I wonder if Vili has found his spear.
This is an outrage!
Our strong...
Festive.
Too festive, and too soon. Fires, fights, and every man soaked in mead. Ugh, this has gone too far.
Hemthorpe could burn before the pyre is lit.
Gods, have I failed, my dear Jarl?
Peace, Tryggvi. I will do what I can to calm things.
Saxon did what? How dare he?
Go, my eyes.
Did what? How dare he insult our culture?
He's a dead man if I ever get my hands on him.
Ah, greet! Brat de la Eirum for Aldastabir!
Help! Fire! Save my vote!
What is this Boda you speak of?
A gift without price, fit for a Jarl's lips. But hurry, it catches flame! Save my Voda, it burns!
Shit! I
have to repair that! This is your Voda. I managed to save it from the licking flames.
You dared Surtur's heat, yes! A most potent drink, distilled from grain by the Rus of Kiev. Dip your horn and have a drink.
A bit of drink in the belly never hurt. Pass the bottle. Hemingr's men fighting roosters?
Dragons with mighty claws! Save me from their wrath!
Thank you, mighty Thor. You've saved my life.
When you sober up, steer clear of roosters.
They are going to kill him! I told him not
to do it. Now he's locked up in the house.
Come out, you dung-eating rat!
What madness is this?
You dare wash our beloved Hemingir with your filth!
I asked you a question, friend.
There's a Saxon within. One stupid enough to try sending Hemingir to heaven over Valhalla. Now he cowers behind a locked door!
I only did right by his immortal soul!
You will get what is right for you!
Calm yourselves, all of you. I will speak with him, unmask his true intentions.
Get that stain out here now!
The people are quite upset.
Leave me be! I did nothing wrong!
You should walk out of here on your own, before you cannot walk at all.
Yes, yes, I'll walk. Don't hurt me, please! There's a key there. If you open the door, I will follow you out. You've got the key! Use it!
Get that stain out here! You'll pay for your wrongs, desecrator!
Enough! Let him speak to explain himself.
I loved Hemingir! I swear! I only want him to fly free in the kingdom of God!
So you drench his body with your filth waters?
Was it your Christian holy water?
Of course! I anointed him in the name of the Lord!
Shut your mouths, both of you. Your antics have outlasted their welcome. Now go! Order seems to have been restored. Now to trick me, to let him know.
Trick!
Thank you, yes, then now!
I've calmed the guests as much as they can be in their grief.
They mourn. It is to be expected. Still, thank you.
And how do you feel, old friend?
I mourn more deeply than most, I think.
Hemingir would be proud of what you have accomplished here. All you have done for him.
I hope so.
This ache will pass, Tryggvi. With time.
Yes, it will.
The Althing is tomorrow, and a Jarl must be chosen. I should speak with Sunimir about this.
Did you consult the Volva? And were your questions answered?
Some questions were answered. Others, I must answer myself. Do you think there's a place for Vili in our settlement? He expressed a desire to live and work with us.
Will he not be Jarl of this Shire before the day's end?
That remains to be seen. Some are more eager to see Tryggvi in the high seat.
Eivor, Tryggvi has no intention to lead. He feels duty-bound to follow his master into death.
Absolutely not. My father would never allow such foolishness.
How else can I honor my Jarl, old as I am? This is no country for me. The future is yours, Vili.
The flames of this pyre will burn for my father. You must live. I forbid you to follow him into death.
I will not let you sacrifice yourself.
Do you forbid me as a friend, Vili? Or as our new Jarl?
As a man who would see you come to your senses.
Vili. Tryggvi. Each man wears one of Heming's boots, with both men unwilling to seize the other.
Does the world need such useless, dithering men? Why not stake a claim yourself? Take this Shire for your own.
It is not my place.
Your place is anywhere you lay your head, any hill you summit, any silver you take for your own. Do not limit yourself to niceties.
Nottinghamshire deserves a leader to admire, a man the people can trust. Most love Vili, and he loves them. But he lacks the will to be leader. He could learn, but does he wish to? And Tryggvi, sturdy and wise and loyal to the legacy Heminger Jarl left behind. Almost to fault, but he is old, and his thrill for living has fled him. Hardly inspiring.
You cannot! I will not allow it!
I am not asking for your permission. Only your forgiveness.
Gods, Eivor! Put a stop to this fool's death wish!
Tryggvi has no Jarl to serve, Vili. He's free to set his own course to the ocean's edge, to trade this world for the next. As are you, Vili. Our lives belong to us.
Thank you. Thank you, Eivor. Vili, do not misplace your anger on friends who speak what they believe is truth.
Do as you must, Tryggvi. I will miss you, old friend.
And I you, my boy. I must prepare myself for the flames. Body and spirit.
Eivor!
Suniva.
Picts were spotted moments ago, lurking in the thicket. Vili gave chase.
Ah, stick. He should have roused me first. Show me where he went.
Let us wake the others. The dark is lousing with Picts.
Tell no one of this. The last thing we need is a dozen more bodies for Heming's pyre. This will be a fine tale to tell after the All-Thing. But until then, we stay quiet.
His rage has consumed him, Eivor. All this anger, this sadness, it has truly taken form.
Arstig was never one to temper his emotions. This was bound to happen. He should have been more vigilant.
Do not blame yourself, Drengur.
He always had me to watch his back. His children, and again now. If this rampage is what he needs to rid himself of the sick that binds him, I will at least make sure he does not hurt himself.
Thank Odin he has the mighty Wolfkist as his shadow.
There are things we do for family, Suniva. No questions asked. For you, I would have done the same. For any of the Raven Clan.
We know, Drengur. That is why we are sworn to you. Here, Eivor. This was where Vili saw the scout killed and then charged after the enemy ahead. I will head back to Hemthorpe and make sure our ravens stand vigilant. Return to us safely, Drengur.
I should be cautious around here.
Stop, Billy! They're gone. It is done.
I've seen boosters fight with more spirit.
Oddly enough, so have I.
That sound. Is it thunder?
Footsteps.
We need to fall back. Follow me. Quickly!
Thank you.
Thrilling, was it not? Just like when you were children, getting into trouble and getting away.
Save your honey words for when we get out of here alive, Arstic.
Not good.
Ah, my sword's Thunderhammer. That quickened the blood.
Wild and reckless, like our first battles together. Remember the island north of Stavanger?
I do. Kjertve the Cruel trained his berserkers there.
Great lumbering fools, foaming at the mouth. We taunted them from the treetops.
And the drunk one, remember? Naked as the morning. Froze his cock off trying to find us.
Then fell to humping a snowdrift.
Were you glad to hear from me?
I did wonder what trouble you'd been up to. But I smiled at hearing your name. And I wondered if you had taken after your father. If you were now leading your clan.
Well, you have your answer. I'd sooner take after a troll and leave this clan in your hands.
That I will not do.
When my father was named Jarl, he had no one to help him, and still he triumphed. But I am not my father. I simply want to roam. Do you think Sleipnir would be content bound to a stable, no matter how glorious it may be? Hey, what is that for?
You have friends, Vili. You have family and clan.
Of course. I know that.
You can't roam forever. Keep that in mind. You are surrounded by those who love you. And that will not change, unless you push it all away.
You speak a truth. I understand.
Troll-faced Arstic.
A chicken draugr. Is such a thing possible? For that does not seem possible.
Voda, too. A warder infused with fire. I do not lie. Your father's death aside, Vili. This has been good. Fun, even.
Do you ever wonder what might have happened if we had not been separated by the North Sea so early in our lives? What adventures we would have had. The raids, the battles, the glory. I even think about what we might have been to each other.
I have. Fondly, and often enough that it sometimes seemed you never left. Maybe you never did.
I want you, Eivor. Your warmth. Your touch.
Like this?
I cannot say how I will feel tomorrow, Eivor.
Shut up, Vili. Vili, you know that this was a momentary heat, just a flickering flame?
Yes. We let our passions set sail just this once. I should get back. Rest. The funeral will still be there when you wake up fully.
Billy, gone already. To prepare for the funeral, I imagine. So many Danes, so many Norse. This will be the send-off Heminger deserves. All the funeral preparations are in order. Be patient, Heminger Jarl. We are about to send you on your final journey.
Brothers, sisters!
Eivor, my father sets forth on his final voyage.
May the winds favor him.
The nobles have offered up their funeral gifts. All but you. Present what you have, and the celebration may begin.
I have it here. Shield bearing the sign of the Web of Weird. Woven into this shield as you wove your spirit into our lives. May the skulls sing of you as the gods embrace you. Feast, my friend, in the halls of the free and brave.
Stand at my side.
Speak from your heart, Heminger-san.
Today we mourn the passing of Heminger Jarl of Snottinghamshire. My father. Our father. He was a towering force. A strength to fear and admire. Now gone. Yet together we are the example of his greatness. I see him in each of you. His love for battle, but also peace. For wisdom, sorrow, and joy. His generosity. His spirit. In you I see his life. And his love of drink. Gods, did he love drink! We are these things because he was these things. Father, we shall be to our children what you were to us. And when they are ready, we will meet you again.
You have made this old man proud, each of you.
And you us.
My
9 days, one eye hung from the tree. 9 worlds he saw. 9 runes he found. 9 nights he bled.
Father, receive your loyal servant. Give him a fine farewell.
Sunniva, ride to Hemthorpe and prepare the longhouse for the Althing. The next Jarl will soon take his seat.
Have they given their Jarl a fine farewell?
They have. None drink so well and so deeply as Clan Hemingerson.
The declaration of succession must happen soon, before we are too drunk and exhausted to remember our names.
I agree. Call on those who must attend. The Althing will begin shortly.
Eivor!
You look uneasy.
I'm not so drunk I cannot stand, but hang on to me a moment.
You do your father proud by this celebration, and by taking his seat. He wanted this, Vili.
I mourn for myself, Eivor. For us. You know my heart. It beats for the passion of battle heat. Not this.
As did your father's heart when he was our age. But he grew up, and so shall we. Now go on, man. Show them you are a Hemingerson.
People of Hemthorpe, of Ulkerthorpe, of Nottinghamshire. We honor neither Tryggvi nor my father by continuing to mourn. These men dedicated their lives to bettering all of Nottingham.
They died in that service. Now, I humbly pledge my life to following in their path. And I ask each of you to rise. Be to me what Tryggvi was to my father. Together, we shall build the world they wish to build.
You've already learned that people prefer shorter speeches to long ones, Vili Jarl.
It will take time to wear that title with comfort. My father never swore a formal oath with your clan. There was no need, for you are family. Let it be known, the Hemingers and Clan Raven are true sworn friends from this day forward. Do you accept?
Aye.
Well?
Be fair, be just, and call upon us often. Our stick.
I'm sure I will.
And we want to know about this. It is time I return to the settlement.
One more, and only because you all have such good taste. Now, this one begins a long time ago.
Eivor, have you seen Wallace?
Bring fair tidings, Renri. Heminger Jarl in Snottinghamshire has passed, but his clan remains allied to us.
Sad news, but you made the best of it.
I saw my old friend Vili on my visit. He is their Jarl now, and he has pledged to aid us in times of need. I want to see the Alliance map. My mind is fixed on Sussex. Basim and I have a chance to save Sigurd. But we will need an army.
I believe you do. Now is the time to strike, before Fulki decides Sigurd is of no more use to her.
I will go now, and I will bring Sigurd back with me. That is a promise.
Good. I will send word to our allies at once. Meet with Basim when you can. He should be in Croindonne by now.
Eivor, if you've a moment to spare...
Petra, what is wrong?
It's my brother. Wallace was meant to return hours ago, but I've seen neither hide nor hair of him. He's usually punctual. I'd like to search the woods for him, but alone I fear I would have little luck. Would you join me? Two could cover much more ground.
We should go now. Do you know where to start?
Near Peterborough. It's where he buys his tanning liquids. I know he sometimes makes camp at a crossroads between here and there. We can retrace his steps. With luck, he hasn't done anything foolish.
Is he prone to that sort of thing?
Never. That's why his absence worries me. I told you how we found him, didn't I?
You did. Led by a white elk to a lost babe in the woods. A fated encounter.
Fated, yes. As if gifted from one guardian to another, he was bestowed on us like a babe among the reeds.
Over there. He may have stayed somewhere nearby.
If he did, he left traces. Oh no, Eivor!
I feel stronger already. A set of tools. If they belong to Wallace, why would he take them from his satchel here?
That leads below ground, to who knows where. Let's keep our wits about us.
Careful, Petra. Look at his eyes. There's something wrong. Almost pleasant.
Someone was wounded. A knife attack, I think.
Wallace stayed here. Seems he made something to eat. Why would he leave his campsite? Where could he have been going?
Must be Wallace's clothes. The trousers are wet. Probably pissed himself.
Oh my god, Eivor! Eivor, come this way!
What have you found?
I saw it, Eivor. I saw him nearby.
Wallace?
The white elk! The white elk that brought me to Wallace years ago. It was there! I saw it there!
Are you certain?
As sure as I see you now!
Petra, where are you?
I'm here!
Here! Come!
Petra! Hello?
Mimir, guide me. Have I lost her too? Ah, the elk. He will know where she has gone.
I'm sorry to trouble you, Lord.
Eivor, nice to see you here.
Are you the white elk Petra told me about?
Of course I am. Look at me.
It may be you can help me. Petra has disappeared. I need to find her before the sun slips away.
No, no. Petra hasn't disappeared. She's close, very close, and waiting for you. Follow me.
You are the guardian of this place. You live a comforting life. Out here among the hills and dales of Mercia.
Oh, I get on, you know. I eat, I sleep, I frolic. I want for nothing and enjoy every moment. It is a decent life. And what are you and Petra doing out here, lurking about in the woods? Hunting, maybe?
In a way, yes. We are looking for her brother, Wallace. She's been waiting for him all day.
Oh, my dear, yes. Where could Wallace be? Oh, where? Oh, where indeed?
Ha! Is Petra near? I fear we've lost her.
She was here a moment ago.
What is happening?
I cannot stay. Not here, not now.
Bring evil back to Suttungus Hall!
Watch my back.
What have you done with Petra?
What have you done to Petra? Answer me!
Eivor, stop! I'm here!
I will make them talk. I will crush you! I must know the truth! I must know where you are!
Eivor, I am right here. There is no need to question this carrion further.
Yes. Sorry.
Now come! I believe I know where we'll find Wallace. Up there! His trail leads this way!
Petra, I met your old friend, the White Elk. But he vanished before my eyes, before I found you.
You were visited!
For a time, we talked until he vanished into the empty air. A shame, really. I enjoyed his presence.
Oh, look there!
This is strange, Seda Petra. Where are you?
Come on! I'm up here!
Petra! How are you doing this?
There's no trick to it. I think about it, and it works. Easy as walking. Try it.
Again? Petra, how?
Just come to me. I'll show you.
How can I do that, Petra?
Yes, just try it. Move! Run in a straight line!
No, 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 no! Too far! Too far! Amazing!
You did it, just like your Sunan! And not a scratch on you! Now let's go. Wallace should be over there.
Are you sure Wallace is here? I see no one.
I believe so. We should ask the rabbits. They will know something.
Of course. The rabbits.
We've been here before.
This is where the wolves attacked us.
Right. Let us hope their spirits are not restless and that they do not wake to maul us.
Oh no! The wolf spirits have wakened!
Good day, Squirrel. I hope I'm not intruding, but have you seen my brother Wallace? This one doesn't speak rabbit!
Petra, hurry!
We're home. Full circle with nothing to show for it.
So what are we looking at?
Wallace? You stone-brained stoat! We've been looking for you!
And here I am, freshly rested and ready to work.
Your day's late!
I was carrying quite a burden coming home. Slowed me down some, so I made a camp and picked some mushrooms for a nice soup. Turns out I picked some funny mushrooms. Sent me into a tizzy. Tore off my clothes, woke up naked and bruised in the woods. So I snuck home, naked as the day God made me, and grabbed some clothes. Now I'm off to get my tools.
Mushrooms.
So the elk. Just another dream.
Maybe so. But don't scoff at dreams. They are often worth more than our waking hours. I may still be buzzing from these mushrooms, but this is nice.
I had fun today. Maybe we could do it again, without the mushrooms.
We could. But I will have to ask the rabbits for permission.
can hardly believe it's you. The one fated to save my people.
That woman seems to know me.
Who's your lord?
This one...
Feeling a little.
May I see your stores?
Ah, that one's pretty good. Sad to send this one away, but it will make me proud. All my pieces are good, but that one's very good. After God. Done for now.
I have to go. See you soon.
May they sing of your deeds and my craftsmanship.
Far away, a place of mystery, wonder, and a temple to a hidden god.
Hello, Eivor.
What have you got for me today?
Yes! I can resell these.
Only a fool would pass this up. I'll be sure to keep these in stock for you. Give it a try. Nothing else?
I'm off. Be well, friend.
I hope to see you soon. Now, this one begins a long time ago at a desert oasis, far away. A place of mystery, wonder, and a temple.
I would like to see what you have in stock.
You like the looks of that one? Is that what you want? You have a keen eye for quality. Ready for battle.
I will see you later, friend.
Put that gear to good use out there.
Breadbasket of Wessex, land of plenty.
This giant spawn must die.
Thank you.
Go.
I'll follow you, Eivor, to glory and Valhalla!
To me, warrior. Let gold and glory be our meat and mead.
You wouldn't be the first man to fall asleep on watch, but you would be the loudest.
I did not mean to fail you, Guthrum Jarl. It was only for a moment. I was so tired.
As are we all, boy. We marched hard to get here. Still, let's not disappoint me again. You hear?
My Jarl, I'm sorry.
You must be Eivor. I've heard much of you, young one. They say you're something. We'll see.
I am Eivor of the Raven Clan. I have carved a furrow through this teeming land, and the Skalds sing loud of my deeds.
Those who boast have something to prove. The great have no need for it.
Eivor hopes to rescue Sigurd from the madwoman Fulke, now ensconced in Porchester Fortress. If you wish to crown yourself King of Wessex, Porchester must fall. An alliance here serves us both.
You promised a great army, but you couldn't breach a Crone's garden with what you have assembled here.
This is not the sum of my forces. Where are the rest?
Your allies are on their way. We must be patient.
We cannot wait for them. We march as soon as we're able.
With these numbers, are you keen to see Valhalla today?
I will not sit on my heels while Sigurd rots in that she-dog's care.
We might muster for an attack in the woods east of Porchester. But there are scouts between there and here.
Scouts I can manage. Point me at them and I will blind Fulke's eyes.
One walks the road between Brigsworth and Chichestre. Another on the riverbank, north of Crowley. A third keeps watch on the hills south of Croendene. But I warn you, these are all we know of. There may be more.
A risk we must take. I will find the scouts. You move the men into position near Porchester.
That is a rash gamble, Ravenfeeder. If we are spotted, we will be vulnerable.
If you want victory, come now or not at all. Every hour we waste could be Sigurd's last.
You had better be all they promised.
Snake.
You need a leash. Stay close.
Well, then, I'm feeling for Heldan. Shoot on that head.
My friend. See you, old friend. They said there would be a scout on this hill. smell blood on the air. Death is close. Did someone find the scout before me? Slain by wolves. My work has been done for me. Aiden, be my eyes. A scout patrols the riverbank north of Crowley. Be my eye. Spread your wings. Go, Sunan. See, Sunan. careful now.
Stop you.
Remain steadfast.
Okay, scout. Blindside,
idiot.
Orders from Fulke. I should show this to Basim once I've dealt with the others.
Christ!
to die!
Can't do this alone. Hey, come here a moment! Look! Must be treasure!
Give me a hand over here!
Away with you!
I need your eyes, my friend.
Longer.
Basim and Guthrum will be waiting in the woods east of Porchester.
Help me with this.
Hey, what's going on?
We should be rising! Flay on! Gafunen, for your relief! Shoot them! Shoot your own men! Thank you.
Interesting.
Is that?
The scouts are dead, and you're safely encamped. I told you this would work.
Time will tell.
Any eye that saw you has been dimmed by death.
You are not short on confidence. That much is clear.
I found something of interest on one of the scouts. Fulke has news of Croindon's fall. She's gathering men and supplies, perhaps to weather a siege.
If she is allowed to dig in at Porchester, it might be months before we can get Sigurd out.
Do you still say I'm reckless in my haste, Guthrum?
Saxons! Saxons from the west!
I say your haste has put us squarely in the shit.
Fulke was forewarned. There must have been more scouts than we knew of.
What's done is done. Save your breath for the fight.
Who wants some?
Go meet your god.
This place is of your making.
Kill them here. I'm behind the walls of Porchester. Either way, they die.
Thank you.
Porchester! They flee like rabbits!
Then we chase them like hounds!
That ugly bastard's head is mine!
Not if I get there first, Slowars!
Leave him! The day is already won!
Found you, Saxon! You'll join your friends soon enough! Is it for that withered bag of skin you fight? For Sigurd the Sickling!
If Sigurd dies today, I'll find your corpse and piss on it!
False deities like a plague to this land. But you know nothing of those who truly decide our fate.
I decide your fate today, Saxon.
I am ready for my final journey. Let me see what lies beyond.
I will not. Go and tell Fulke what you saw today. Tell her Eivor is coming to tear her heart from her chest.
I will tell Fulke her opponent is a weakling who does not have the stomach to finish what they started.
He is dead,
Eivor. You will regret this mercy!
You are wounded, Broda. Let me bear your brother to the camp.
He was always quicker than me. Beat me out of the womb by mere moments. Now he goes faster.
Stripling, I warned you the risk was too great!
Peace, Guthrum. It is Fulke who merits your wrath, not Eivor.
You have not seen the half of my wrath. How many of my men now lie dead on account of this glory hoarder?
In spite of our losses, we claimed victory here. Arguing over blame will not bring the dead back.
If this is what a RavenClan victory looks like, I cannot wait to see what happens when you lose.
What happened here?
Uba, Soma, you come at a black hour.
And too late to bloody our blades. More's to pity.
I hope to take Porchester with this one. He is forewarned now. I have no more appetite for this. I will go west.
Go then. But know you leave me in a time of need.
What you need is to swallow your pride, Raven Feeder. Listen to wiser heads than yours.
Eivor?
I am no errant child to be talked down to by my elders.
No. You are supposed to be a leader. So listen now. You want your Jarl back? You must be cold as frost. Bravery is your enemy as often as your friend. We do not dash ourselves against hopeless courses. We arrive unexpected. Strike swift. Gather your allies. Pick your moment. Then, and only then, you crush them. You can triumph yet. Go with the wisdom of Odin, the power of Thor, the wit of Freya. Go and find your brother.
Guthrum spoke in anger. But there is wisdom in what he says.
We will wait for our allies before the attack. Until then, we have work to do. First, we need a new camp. The Saxons think we have retreated, but we will draw even closer. Here.
Arrive unexpected.
Eadke, Stow, Lufina, right there ahead of me. Together, we will bring them down.
It brings me no pleasure to fight my own people, but a debt is a debt.
Besides, they're men of Wessex, Alfred's folk, no brothers of yours.
We will set off immediately. Together, we will fall upon them as Thor's hammer.
After that, we should strike at Fulke's supplies all across Suffolk.
Yes. If she is allowed to dig in at Porchester, we will lose our chance to rescue Sigurd.
The letter I found on the scout mentioned Bridgeworth, Guildford, and Crowley.
They produce weapons in Crowley, food in Guildford. Bridgeworth is a stronghold. Many Saxon swords there.
Uba, I need your axe arm at Guildford. Soma, you and your men will aid me in Crowley.
Count on us.
I will go to Bridgeworth and take a measure of things there.
Good. I will join you after I've dealt with the Saxon camp.
A lion's heart and a crow's cunning. Guthrum judged you too swiftly.
We have work to do. Let's be about it.
Soma and Uba, I apologize. I would have liked to offer a better welcome after your long journey.
I'm only sorry we could not be here sooner.
We need a short while to organize the men. Then we'll set off as soon as we're able.